Hey guys, Kevin here. The question is, for the DTF printer, is 1390 based better or L1800 based better? Let me give you the quick answer before you watch the whole video. They all pretty good. L1800 is better for unclogging. So if this is your first printer, probably the unclogging can help you to make this printer last longer. However, if you know how to unclog, you can also do the same for 1390. On the other side, 1390 is better at maintenance. If there's no other problems, if you do your homework, do the daily maintenance, you might feel the 1390 is smoother. This is production L1800, so let me show you. First thing is the cleaning time. If you follow my other video, you know that I do cleaning every half an hour or 5 shirts. You're going to see the actual cleaning takes about a minute and 30 seconds. But after that, Epson added in the waiting time. So basically the printer just sits there and blinking the power lights. During this time, you cannot print, so basically your print job is just waiting there. And also sometimes, or like lots of times, maybe 80% times, the printer errs out on this waiting, so it just waits forever. And you have to shut down the printer and restart it. You can see this one aired out, it's really often. So you can see I shut down the printer and restart it. And now I can print. So it takes me 4 minutes from the time I press cleaning until I figure out this aired out and start printing. However, for 1390, it's going to take the same amount, about 1 minute 30 seconds to clean itself. However, after that, it rarely aired out. I never encounter anyone aired out. It automatically go into the printing mode. See, 1 minute and 35 seconds and no waiting. Now it's printing, so you cut off 2 minutes from each cleaning. And the second thing is how it prints. This 1800, and I didn't turn the sound off. The vacuum platform automatically turn on when it start printing and cut off when it's not printing. You're going to hear that for every couple swaps, it's going to stop at the capping station. See, it stopped there right now. So you have to go back to the capping station to wipe and clean itself. The L1800 goes print, then clean, print and clean. So how is it going to affect its printing time? We're going to print 4 all white shirts. Notice if you print all white, it will be a lot faster than you print white and color. So we just use this all white because we got 50 orders today. So it takes about 12 minutes and 20 seconds. If you added the cleaning afterwards, it's going to be like 15-16 minutes. If you see how 1390 prints, use the left whisk pad to clean itself. So it just naturally goes here as a part of its printing operation, so it doesn't need to stop. Also, as a caveat, you can also monitor this whisk pad and determine how strong is your white during the printing. Because it's flushing out all the colors, you can even reduce your cleaning in between your runs. So will this reduce over time for each run? We're going to print the exactly same white shirt, just like what we did at L1800. You can see it finished in 9 minutes 34 seconds, 3 minutes faster than L1800. Do not powder your film yet. Remember, we talked about a smooth transition between cleaning and the print. Now hold down the ink button, and that will trigger cleaning. And when you start cleaning, you're going to send your next job. So when you finish the cleaning, automatically it starts printing again. The printer now is cleaning. Cleaning time is 1 minute 40 seconds. Right after that, it's going to start printing. And now is the time that you can do your cut and powdering. So in about 2 minutes, it's going to automatically start pruning. And you can see it start pruning right now. You can see what I mean, the 1390 is a much smoother machine to work with if you have a lot of shirts to print. It doesn't mean the 1390 is a better printer than L1800. I'll have another video and I'll talk about the pros of getting L1800. Think about what's your habit of printing and can this merge into your existing workflow. The 1390, although faster, it also has its limitation on the droplet size and the print density. Another limitation is that the 1390 will need an ink reset after a couple runs. If you forgot about this, and it's going to be just sitting there and waiting for you to push buttons. See, this one almost done, and then it's just waiting you to reset the ink. So you have to push, and third time, push three times, and they go back to printing. We finally finish at 10 minutes and 20 seconds. It's not a problem for me because I have multiple printers, so when this needs a reset, I always can see it. But for you, you probably want to get a timer and the timing from the last reset, so it can remind you when it needs a reset. Okay, this order came in at 6 p.m. and I did 050 at 9 p.m. It usually takes me about 40 seconds to press a shirt, another hour, and I'll be ready. The customer's flight is 5 a.m. tomorrow, so we get plenty of time to finish this and deliver it. Carolina at night. Oh, by the way, BCH means Best Carolina Homes. Try to be a realtor, but end up here. Good night, everybody.